My friends, welcome. So, just a quick recap from where we left off in the last episode. We dropped down from the sky. We set up a factory. I then built the foundations for a new factory. I destroyed what I had, and then I set up all of this. Okay, we're all caught up. Done. Huzzah! What I'm going to do now, I could set up the copper, because we do generally need copper as well, but I am actually producing an awful lot of, concrete, at the moment, and it's not being produced inside my factory, and I don't like that. So I am going to fix it right now. There we go. I'll take you as well. Okay. So, I'm going to leave this monstrosity of a balancing system here, because essentially these mergers and splitters balance from a impure node, which gets virtually no resources coming out, and a pure node, which gets the maximum number of resources coming out, so they can be balanced between two machines. So, come with me, and we are going to set up some concrete. And what I'm thinking is there's no better spot for that than in this little corner, because once we have the two concrete machines set up, we just need it to go into one little storage box. So I'm going to set up the storage box now. That looks about center. Yeah, I'm happy with that. So then this is going to be where all my concrete will come out. Obviously, we're going to need two of our constructors. That looks like it's not going over the edge. Excellent. And then this one. There we go. Alright. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set these up for concrete and just basically bring those lines over. And then we will see where we're at. So give me a second for some movie magic. Alrighty. And hooked up. So I had to go over the top because I didn't want to interfere with the front of the building. So let me just give you a quick tour to show you the travel of the concrete. So first of all, this one here, we had to get it up, so I had to just, you know, get it on here and then come up on top of this other merger and then on top of the miner, because we wanted it to come over here and then just up the top here before I realized that, oh, we're actually going all the way down the bottom. I then brought it over here and then connected it up there. So, as you can see, the bottom bit here is perfectly clear. We can walk through. When we get vehicles, we can drive through. No problem. And the other one, I just simply got it to go around here, then up along here, zigzag over this way, to also go up along here, to briefly stop on top of the other conveyor belt, come over here, through this tree, all the way along here, to zigzag and snake its way around this little bit of a landscape to then come down here. And I learnt my lesson from last time, so it went all the way down to come down here, woo, before having to go up because then we needed the clearance. So all the way up to the top to then come over here before making its final journey down the little elevator into the machines. Nice and efficient, perfect. So now, we just have to set these up to be concrete and then connect them with power. The good thing with the concrete is you don't actually need a smelter, because the concrete itself just goes directly into the constructors. I apparently need some more wire, so give me just a second. Okay, wire time. So you'll probably notice that I essentially put down a lot of these power poles. That's essentially because I don't want to have to at any point redo my entire electrical system. So I essentially just put down a lot of the power poles, especially at the beginning, so at any point I can essentially just grab one from anywhere and get it to go. It'll be a lot easier to manage once we actually have the walls set up, but until we have the walls, it's just kind of there. But for now, because these two things are producing the concrete, and we want to easily send it through to the storage bin, I set up a merger here. The key thing with the mergers is you have the orange and blue arrows. Obviously, the direction they're pointing is the direction the material is going, so orange being in, blue being out in this case. It's a very simple way to do it, but again, if you want right corners, just go back to and then in. And then... I'm happy with that. That's nice. It's aesthetically pleasing while saving some space. Excellent. So now this one here will start to gather just the concrete over time. And then we'll be set for concrete, because as you can see, it's already just powering through. We will at some point in the future inevitably need more concrete, but that will just come down to most likely just increasing the miners so they can pull more resources, and the conveyor belts so they can move more resources. So that'll be super fun to upgrade all of that when it happens, but for now, we've concreted. So, hooray! There's really not much explanation that concrete needs, because it's just going from the miners into the constructors, so nice little short episode. So on that note, happy concreting, and I will see you all in the future. Okay, bye!